Hi there and welcome to Workast. In today's session, I'm going to be talking to you about the paid features that you get when you upgrade to a paid plan with Workast. Okay, so here is a space. With the paid plan, you get unlimited subtasks. So here we have a task, create account for client with basic details. You can see that this is overdue. So what I'm going to do is create a subtask. So this is a subtask, breaking down the larger task into a smaller task or step by step so that this can be action by another team member or the same team member who is assigned. Okay, so this is subtask. You can create as many as you want. They look exactly like a parent task. With a due date, assignee, followers, and the comment section, and you can add tags. And so that brings me to my next feature that we include in Workast, which is tags. So here we have the tag, and basically a tag is a way for you to categorize your work. Since this is high priority now because the original task, the parent task, is overdue, I'm going to tag it as high priority. The great thing about tags is that when you start using it, you can then run reports based on this tag. And I will show you that a little bit later on because you do get unlimited reporting with your paid plan of Workast. Tags are custom to you and your team. You can create them to be whatever you want. It can be, you know, based on the status. It can be based on your internal processes. It can be the client. It can be basically anything that is customized to you and your team. Okay, so the next thing that we also include in our paid plan is task dependencies. So basically, task dependencies is based on one task being dependent on the other before it can be completed. Okay, so we're gonna click right here. We're gonna click this three dots here and we're gonna add a dependency. So send contract and additional documents in Kensington Market, that's the client. So this task is now dependent on this task. So I can't complete this task unless this has been done. So it says you must complete all the dependencies before completing this task. So I know that the contract needs to be sent before documents can be signed and received by the client. Okay. Okay, so another thing that is included in your paid plan is private spaces. So this space here is public. That means that anyone can join it in the team. Anyone that's here is already in the team, and then you can add or remove participants from the space here. But a private space means you can create a space which only certain people can have access to it. So if you're dealing with confidential information, if you're dealing with a private project that not everyone in the team needs to join, you can make it private. And again, you can choose who is going to be the participant of the space. Okay, you can check if it's private because it has the little lock here. And also when you're creating a new space, you can choose the privacy here. So privacy is only those invited can join the space. So with a paid plan with Workast, you can choose who can join spaces and whether they're public or private. Okay, with Workast Premium, a paid plan, you also get unlimited amount of spaces and unlimited amount of templates. So a template, we've been using it here at Aura Market in this example here, is that whenever we get a new client, we've created this template, which is basically how we onboard them. And we've got the client preparation, the setting agenda, and the project, like what needs to be done. So a template is great because you can create all these tasks ahead of time. And every time you get a new client, you can just import this template into the space or use it to create the space itself. For example, when you're creating a space here, you would choose which template you're going to be using. So then all of these tasks are imported into the space and you don't need to recreate them again. Another thing that you get with a paid plan with Workast is unlimited meetings. So meetings is a new way to run your meetings with Workast. Basically, you invite Workast into your meeting and we send out the agenda to your team members and they can click on, you know, the agenda here and see everything that is planned for that meeting. For example, we have this strategy meeting here. I've written up the agenda. I've put some points here that we're going to discuss. You can even add images. And then you also have a place to write meeting minutes. So when you're actually in the meeting, you can write minutes in here. And you can also create tasks. So when you're in your actual meeting, when you have tasks allocated that need to be done by certain people, you can actually assign them to your team members. You know, the thing about meetings is that when you write an agenda or write meeting minutes, the action items kind of go, undone because we don't know where they go or they're not being, a task isn't created. So this is a real way to keep track of all the things that you really need to do. You have a way to join the meeting through Google Meet or join by phone. So that's that there. You've got everything here to run your meetings better. So this is a great way for you to have more effective meetings, have everything in one place, and you'll be able to see everything that needs to be done here with your meetings. With a paid plan with Workast, you also get unlimited notes. So notes basically is like a document that you can create, guidelines or do blog articles or have anything that you need to write in a document, you can do it in Workast. The great thing about Workast is that it sits in a space. So everything related to human resources is going to be here. For example, we've got our vacations, time off, sick leave and holidays policy. It's here and everyone can access it and they know where to find the document. They don't need to go into a Google Drive and start searching it. And try and find where that document is. You've got everything right here in the space and it's labeled correctly. So you've got everything here with your notes. So a really unique thing with Workast is we have a two-way calendar sync. So what that means is when you sync your calendar to Workast, you can get all of these tasks pushed into your work calendar. So these tasks, when you create a new task, it's going to be pushed into your work calendar. Then you can see all your tasks and your meetings in one place. You can complete the tasks in your work calendar by deleting the event and it will update in Workast. Our two-way calendar sync means that if you do something in Workast, it is reflected in your work calendar. And if you do something in your work calendar, such as update the task, change the due date, it's also reflected in Workast. So this is a very unique feature that we have that many other competitors do not have. Okay, so I wanted to talk to you about our extensions. You have a lot of different extensions here that you could add to each space. And one of the extensions I wanted to take note of is that you get unlimited time tracking with your paid plan of Workast. So what that means is that you can add the amount of time you've worked on a particular task. For example, let's go into the onboarding call with the client. If I want to jot down how much time I've taken, you know, preparing this information and doing the work for this task, I can. So then, you know, if you're billing your client, if you're billing your client for the hours that they use with you, then you have a spreadsheet of everything that you've done for the clients. So there you go. You've got Sarah Harris logged 1 hour of time for this client. Then you can actually run a spreadsheet which shows all the tasks that have time put on them. You can do it per space or you can do it for overall all the spaces. Okay, and the selected date. So I mentioned to you earlier about reporting. So here in the free plan, you actually have some reports here, but with the paid plan, you're able to actually create your own reports, customize them to what you want to see. So right now it's just your tasks, what's due today, what's assigned by you and everything like that. But if you are managing a team, you need to see what everyone is doing, what they've completed, what's overdue and everything. So here you are going to click on plus for the new report. Okay, we're gonna have everything that's pending, and then we can choose who we want to see is assigned the task. So I'm going to do Blake and apply. So this is everything Blake is working on. I can see all the tasks that are overdue and all the tasks that are outstanding. So if you need to manage their capacity and what they're working on, you can do that here. If you need to follow up what tasks are still outstanding, you can do that here. And the opportunities are endless. So, you know, it's not just one person. You can see, you know, like all your team members, what everything that they're working on here. And you can really manage resources from the reporting. We talked about the high priority tag that we created, that we used earlier. So, and I mentioned that you can see all the tasks that are using it in different spaces. Another great tag would be, you know, for approval. So if you are a manager of a team and you need to approve a certain task, you can tag the tasks that need, your team members can tag the task with for approval, and you can go in and have a look at all those tasks that are tagged with for approval, and you can review the work. Okay, so with the high priority report, you have the ability to save it. And once you save it, it goes into your sidebar here. And every time you go back to it, it is refreshed with new data of all the tasks that have the high priority. You can share the report with another team member, which means they will have access to this report from their sidebar. It'll show up here. And then one of the other unique things with a paid plan is that you can actually send this to a team member or to yourself through Slack. So it would be like the reminders that you receive on a daily basis for all the tasks that are assigned to you. But this is specific to this particular report. This report will be sent to you on a daily basis based on what preferences you've set here. So another thing that you get with a paid plan of Workast is that you can add guest users. So guest users will have the access to a particular space. They don't have access to all of the spaces that are in your account. So that means if you have a client that you want to invite to a particular space, you can do that. Or if you have a contractor that's doing some work for you, you can add them as a guest user. Guest users are charged a full fee based on what plan you have, but they are restricted in what they can do. But there is no limit to the number of spaces that they can be invited to, and they will have the ability to complete and view tasks. So one more other thing about a paid plan with Workast. On the professional plan, you are able to choose to only pay for your particular team. So for example, if you have 15 people in your immediate team and you want to pay for them, you can do so, and you won't need to pay for the whole organization. So that is something that we offer in our professional plan to help you just manage your expenses for your team only. So these are the features that you will get with a paid plan of Workast. We hope to have you on the platform. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at support@workast.com. And thank you so much for watching.